What is going on, everyone? In this YouTube video, I am going to show you how to optimize your Amazon PPC campaigns. My name is Tamara T, and on my YouTube channel, I have showed you previously how to optimize Amazon PPC campaigns and why it is so important to your success when you are trying to launch your product on Amazon. So you guys probably already know by now how to download this report from your Seller Central account, so we will not go through those steps. However, I do want to show you what you should be doing with this data that you downloaded from your campaign manager. This is where a lot of people get stuck when they are trying to get sales from their Amazon product, because obviously you need to do some advertising to make money selling on Amazon. Times have changed and you can no more do black hat tactics or giveaways or any of that silly stuff on Amazon. I only teach organic strategies when it comes to Amazon PPC advertising. So let's get started. I downloaded my report from Seller Central, and today we are going to look at optimizing automatic PPC campaigns. So as you can see right here, this is all automatic data. Now, why are we only focusing on automatic data today? Well, that is because without organic search terms, column F right here, without these organic search terms, it's going to be very difficult for us to launch our manual PPC campaign. So in your manual PPC campaign, it is the second type of campaign that you use to get results for your product. So you always should be starting with running an automatic PPC campaign, and then later, depending on what types of keywords you get in your customer search terms, you then launch your manual PPC campaign. Now, 4 years ago, when I started selling on Amazon, I used to launch my manual campaign first, but then again, times have changed, strategies have also changed, and you need to be up to date with everything that is changing on Amazon. So let's get started. So as you can see, I am looking at my ACoS in column M right here. Now there are a lot of columns, but I'm not going to go through all of this information because it's irrelevant to optimizing your PPC campaign. A lot of this information on the right-hand side is just to kind of look at. But what's most important today is to look at the ACoS and the spend and the customer search term. So basically these columns right here. So the first thing you should do is sort your ACoS from big to small. So I sorted from big to small. And by the way, you need Excel to do this. I'm not sure if you can do it on Google Sheets, but I always use Microsoft Excel to optimize my Amazon PPC campaigns. So I have really good data here. And the first thing you need to find out is your profit margin percent. So what is your profit margin percent for your product? You need to know your profit margin percent in order to work with your ACoS in your Amazon PPC campaigns. So let's pretend that my ACoS is 30%. Let's just make it easy, right? So my profit margin is 30%, meaning if my ACoS, my total advertising cost of sales, is greater than 30%, it means that I am now spending money on advertising. Now, you guys may have heard that your ACoS should be under your profit margin percent, and we will do our best to make it work that way, because that would mean that you are profiting from running your Amazon PPC campaigns, but it's not necessarily always that way. So if you are launching your product, I would say within the first to second months of launching your Amazon product and running Amazon PPC campaigns, your ACoS is always very high. You're probably watching this YouTube tutorial because you have a very high ACoS. So in this video, we need to bring that ACoS down. I will explain how you can do that as well. But let's go over the data that we have right here. So the ACoS for this first keyword is polymer clay beads, and my ACoS is 39%. So this is over my profit margin percent by about 10%. In my head, I'm thinking, well, I'm only paying like 10% to get sales from this keyword, so I'm just going to let it go. I'm not going to do anything with this keyword. And when I quickly look at all of my ACoS for my other keywords, I am making money because, as you can see, my ACoS is lower than my profit margin percent, right? It means when I spend money on Amazon to advertise my product, I am making money from all of these keywords. When a customer types in any of these keywords in the Amazon search bar, they see my automatic sponsored ad, and then they buy my product through these keywords and this ASIN right here, which tells me that these keywords are really good. These are really good keywords. But we have to verify again that these keywords made sales. So if I look over here, 7-day total sales, it looks like I only sold one unit for all of these keywords, which does not give me enough information that these are really good keywords. So what I mean by that is, in order for us to say, yes, these are converting keywords that will make me sales and I should put it into my manual PPC campaign, I like to see two or more sales. That's just something that I go by. I always like to see more sales, and that will tell me that, okay, this keyword, jewelry making supplies, is a keyword that customers keep buying from over and over again. So I should put this keyword into my manual PPC campaign. So this is just dummy information, but if this was real information, then I should be seeing more sales for all of these keywords, more than one sale, before I move these keywords into my manual PPC campaign. Now, a very common question that I get asked is, Tamara, is it okay to run a manual campaign if I only have one sale? Well, you can, but the problem with that is it's not really verifying that, yes, this is a good keyword. And it's not like a one-off type of situation, right? So let's pretend that I am a customer and I typed in elastic bracelets, which is a very broad keyword because I am selling polymer clay beads. And when someone types in elastic bracelets, that's a very broad type of keyword. It's not really describing my product indefinitely. And if you base your information off of just this one keyword and one sale, and you move it into your manual campaign, that doesn't give me that confirmation. So I hope you understand what I am trying to say about that. You need more than one sale for your keywords to move into your manual PPC campaign. And to really watch out for the broad types of keywords. So what is a broad keyword? Well, I am selling polymer clay beads, which describe my product indefinitely, right? I am selling polymer clay beads. If you don't know what this is, you can type it into Amazon.com and then this product will pop up and it is my product. But if I am going to run a manual campaign for these broad keywords like elastic bracelets, bracelets kit, what else is broad? Here, this is a broad keyword, but there's no sale on that. Bracelet making kit adults. So these are very broad keywords because it doesn't describe that I am selling beads. It's describing a keyword that is sort of related to beads, but not really. And with these very broad keywords, these are probably the last type of keywords that I would target in my manual PPC campaign because it's so broad. And when it's broad, when a customer searches broad keywords on Amazon and not descriptive targeted keywords like this guy right here, they are more in like a browsing type of mindset. So how many times have you guys went to Amazon.com and you are just browsing, right? You're kind of browsing and you're typing in very broad keywords like this, bracelets kit, but you're not specifically shopping for something. When you have very targeted keywords like polymer clay beads, it tells me that the customer is very interested in just buying polymer clay beads. Therefore, this is a good keyword to target in my manual PPC campaign. So you have to differentiate the difference between broad keywords, very vague keywords like I have highlighted in yellow, compared to very targeted specific keywords. So this is pretty specific as well. Jewelry making beads and quartz, very specific. This customer is shopping for jewelry making beads and quartz. So they want beads and quartz and not just bracelets kit, because a bracelets kit can be anything. So you really have to differentiate between the two and understand the broad and targeted keywords. That is the key to success in optimizing your Amazon PPC campaigns. Another tip that I want to share with you is you have to know the difference between negative exact and negative phrase keywords. So you may have seen that term in your campaign manager in your Amazon Seller Central account. When you put keywords into the negative, there is negative phrase and negative exact. How do you know which one to use? Well, it depends which one you want to take away from the customer. So if we use our bracelets kit, for example, actually, let's go down for keywords that made no sales. Here's a good one. So this keyword made me no sales. So as you can see, there is no ACoS, there is no 7-day total sales. And when I look on the right-hand side right here, there is no ROAS, meaning there is no total return on advertising spend, meaning I made no sales. Again, this is dummy information, so please ignore this. As you can see, I know I made sales because of the ROAS that is showing on column N right here. Anyway, if we go back to this keyword, adult craft kits, I made no sales, right? And this is a very broad keyword. And if I made no sales, and this is a very broad keyword, I should probably eliminate this keyword for customers. Meaning if they type in adult craft kits into the Amazon.com search bar, my sponsor ad will not show up for this keyword. So they will not be clicking on my ad when they type in this keyword because it's already put into the negative phrase and negative exact. So again, how do I know if I want to put adult craft kits into negative phrase or negative exact? So if I put adult craft kits into the negative exact and I want to eliminate only this keyword, then I only put it into negative exact. It's going to eliminate exactly adult craft kits. But if I put this keyword into the negative phrase, it's going to eliminate all the phrases that are contained in adult craft kits. So for example, if someone types in adult craft kits for kids or for boys or for girls, it's going to eliminate all those phrases. So when you put keywords into the negative phrase, you are eliminating all of the phrases. And when you are putting keywords into the negative exact, it's eliminating only this keyword. The biggest mistakes that beginner Amazon sellers make is when they put all of their keywords that are making no sales into the negative phrase, and then you have no more room to get new keywords from customers. So if you put every single keyword into the negative phrase and you want to eliminate it because it's very broad, that's actually a very bad idea because it's going to eliminate all the phrases and therefore you will not get any more keywords in your automatic PPC campaign. Your automatic PPC campaign is kind of like the money tree. This is where it starts. And if you want to squeeze out the sales from your money tree, you need to launch your manual PPC campaign. So if you guys are enjoying this video so far, then make sure you give me a huge thumbs up for this YouTube video and turn on the notification bell so you can get notified every single time I post a new YouTube video. Also, if you are new to selling on Amazon and you do not understand how to make sales, make money on Amazon, you can check out my free training in the YouTube description below. Click on the free training link, enter your name, enter your email address. Watch my training to the very end because you may be qualified to get on a free one-on-one call with myself and my team, and we will help you through this entire Amazon FBA business. Now, getting back to my customer search terms, those are the two main things you have to understand: broad keywords versus targeted keywords, and knowing when to put keywords into the negative exact and negative phrase. Now, there are many other moving parts when it comes to deciding which keywords you should use to launch your product and make a ton of money from it. So make sure you check out this most recent Amazon PPC video. It will help you get further in your Amazon PPC campaigns. Okay, now that we understand the two most important things in your Amazon PPC campaigns, we are now going to move to these ASINs. So one of the biggest problems that Amazon sellers face is they have a lot of ASINs in their search term report. So sometimes when you are going through your customer search term, you notice that you have a lot of ASINs and you're scratching your head wondering, okay, how can I get rid of these? Or why is this happening? or what do I do with these ASINs? Those are all really good questions, and it really comes down to taking this one step at a time. So my first step, how I've been optimizing my Amazon PPC campaigns, is by not running product targeting campaigns, targeting ASINs in the very beginning of launching new products. If you missed what I just said, then just rewind in this video and listen to that again, because it's so important. So there is another option in your manual PPC campaigns, and you can do product targeting. Product targeting is when you choose a competitor. So these are your competitors, right? These are your competitor ASINs. You can choose an ASIN and put your sponsor ad within their product listing. I do not like to do that first because it's going to take up a lot of my budget for my advertising, and I will do this last. Meaning if I have extra budget left over from targeting my winning keywords, I will then create a product targeting campaign to target these ASINs. But there is another problem. Earlier I mentioned that some sellers have a problem where their customer search term is full of ASINs and they cannot get any keywords. You need to get keywords in your customer search term in order to rank your keywords to the very first page so customers can buy your product organically. So long term, you can spend less money on Amazon advertising and focus on organic sales. So if you want to eliminate these ASINs, all you need to do is go into your automatic PPC campaign and turn off substitutes. There is an option for substitutes. You would turn that off, and that should eliminate a lot of the ASINs that you are seeing right here. Why is this a problem? Because as you can see in my spend column, I spent all this money on ASINs, and this money could have been spent on keywords instead. Because remember, keywords is what can get ranked to page one. You cannot rank ASINs to page one. It doesn't work that way. That's not even a term when it comes to advertising on Amazon PPC sponsored ads. You want to rank keywords on page one. So when you are spending a lot of money targeting ASINs, all of that money should be going towards keywords because you want to make it to the first page as quickly as possible. Therefore, you want to eliminate some of the ASINs. Now, if you have made sales for your ASINs, then just leave it there, right? If your ACOS is lower than your profit margin percent, then I would probably leave the ASIN and not do anything with it. Do not put it into the negative. Just leave it because you may be getting a few sales here and there that can help you profit selling on Amazon. But if you are starting your Amazon PPC campaigns, you are on a lower budget, you only want to focus on ranking your keywords to the very first page, which is what I highly recommend you to do, then you can eliminate these ASINs in your automatic campaigns, like I said, by turning off substitutes. I know that right here, it may not seem like a lot of money, but trust me, all of this adds up, right? If you guys are downloading your search term report once a day, like how I do, you will notice that the spend starts to add up. And then you notice that, okay, I don't have enough money to advertise some more, or I'm really on a budget right now. I don't want to spend more than like 20 bucks a day on my automatic PPC campaign. It really adds up. So make sure you pay attention to ASINs and put it as last priority. This is just a strategy that I use. If you heard it from somewhere else that you need to do this, then be careful who you are getting your information from. But in my personal opinion, ASINs should be targeted last, and what we need to focus on is ranking keywords. If you guys need more help with optimizing your Amazon PPC campaigns, then again, please check out my free training in the YouTube description below. Enter your name, enter your email address, and watch the training to the very end because you get to talk to someone on my team who will help you through this entire process. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching today's YouTube video. Stay tuned for my video next week. I'll see you guys in next week's video.